home.
It's hard to imagine America's heartland as a breeding ground for terrorism. Yet when news emerged that two U.S. citizens had been killed in Syria fighting alongside ISIS, the path led back to, of all places, Minnesota. The two men were part of a growing number of young Muslims from Minneapolis and St. Paul who have answered the call of jihad.
At least a dozen young Muslims from here in the Twin Cities have left their homes to travel to the Middle East and join ISIS. Some of them worshiped at this mosque in a quiet suburb of Minneapolis.
An Egyptian-American man allegedly recruited young Somali Muslims from the Al-Farouk Mosque and helped send them to Syria. Mosque officials say they banned Amir Mashal earlier this year when they learned he was preaching jihad. The suspected terror recruiter remains at large.
Usually there's one principal person that is what I call the guide of the person that can take this person in this ideological state and guide them to Syria or wherever it might be.
Bob Fletcher is the former sheriff for Ramsey County, which includes the city of St. Paul. He now works with Somali leaders to battle radicalism in their Twin Cities community, which has seen dozens of young men travel overseas to join terrorist groups in recent years.
They need to procure travel documents. They need to raise money, usually somewhere in the area of $4,000 to $5,000, to help facilitate all the travel that takes place. And plus, they want to have money when they get there. And they need to make sure that someone is purchasing the tickets. That requires a credit card of some source to get to, and they need a driver and a facilitator to get them to the airport.
The recent deadly attacks against Canadian soldiers and the Canadian Parliament by ISIS sympathizers were another reminder of the chaos that just a handful of terrorists can cause on Western soil. It's estimated that as many as 3,000 Western passport holders from places like Canada, Britain, France, and the United States are fighting for the Islamic State. FBI Director James Comey and Attorney General Eric Holder both said recently that 12 Americans are fighting with ISIS in Iraq and Syria. Other Obama administration officials have said that at least 100 U.S. citizens overall have traveled to Syria to join terrorist groups. According to Democrat Congressman Tim Bishop, up to 40 of those American jihadists have already come home.
Those 40 are under FBI attention and surveillance, so they are known and they are being tracked by the FBI.
One suspected American the FBI is tracking starred in this recent ISIS propaganda video called Flames of War, where he executed Syrian troops.
We're here in the 17th Division military base just outside the city of Raqqa, and we're here with the soldiers of Bashar. You can see them now digging their own graves in the very place where they were stationed.
A major concern is that ISIS recruits will return to the United States and carry out attacks here. Fletcher says ISIS sympathizers on U.S. soil who have never traveled overseas but were self-radicalized at home may be the more immediate threat.
I think it's a far greater concern that people that are here and radicalized that haven't gone back might strike out against America.
Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News, Minneapolis.